So, project reviews. We need to establish what went well on the project and what didn't go as well on the project. If you don't have a project review, then it's highly likely that your next project is just going to be another disaster. When I was a trainer, I used to go into companies and they used to say, can you tell me about the worst project that you've ever run in this organization? And I could see people start to look at each other and smile. And then somebody would say, ah, we never talk about that. And I say, well, you must, because what about this new graduate? How are they going to learn about the project if you don't tell them what went wrong on previous projects? If your project has been a disaster, it's a learning experience. If you don't learn from it, your next project is going to be another disaster. So as we've gone through the project life cycle, at the end of the project, we need to do this corporate learning for the next project. Now, if your project takes 3 years, you can't wait until the end of the project to learn about the whole thing. So you may have a little learning event at the end of the initiation phase or at the end of the planning phase. Learning events such that the company gets better at running their projects. Learning from the risks, learning from the estimates, learning which suppliers to use or not use, which contractors are good, which contractors are bad. And one of the things we're going to learn in this project review is learning from our past experience. Remember, we recorded the estimate at the beginning of the project. And as we went through the project, we record the actual, and we can compare the actual with the baseline. And there's going to be a difference. This is where we sit down and we look at the differences in our project plan. And we say to the staff, you estimated 20 hours. You actually booked 40 hours. There's a variance of 20 hours. Why was that? What can we learn from this? If this is a runner repeater type project, so we're going to be doing that task again. We want the next project plan to have a better estimate. Good estimates make good project plans. Good project plans reflect well on the good project managers. Look, it's the way you do this that's important. If somebody says there's 20 hours and they do 40 hours and you get angry with them, you said there was 20 hours, you booked 40 hours, why was that? They're going to go very defensive. When you ask other people for estimates, they're going to start being defensive. If they witness you do this, they're going to think, oh, I think it's going to take me 10 hours, but I'm going to say 20 to cover myself. And any chance of getting an accurate estimate has disappeared. Open and honest. When the guy has done 40 hours, you say, well, you said 20, it was 40. Why was that? And he says, well, I was a bit optimistic. Good. So if we're doing it again, what should be a good estimate? Well, I think I could do it quicker next time, but maybe 30 hours is probably a better estimate. And we're recording these things in a lessons learned log. So another document issued at the end of the project, available as corporate learning for other projects, the lessons that we have learned in this project. And this is one of the main things we're doing at this project audit or project review. Did we achieve the project objectives? On reflection, were they the right objectives? What could we have done better? What have we learnt? What company procedures need changing to help the next project? Which suppliers should we use? Which suppliers shouldn't we use? Did we meet the project goals? Is there another project, now that we've finished this one, as a spin-off? You know, that weren't in the original project aims, but actually it makes sense to continue. What techniques should we use again on other projects? What have we learnt? What have we invented? What process improvements have we made that we need to share with the rest of the organisation? So, lessons learned. Complete that lessons learned document and circulate it around your organisation. Have a look at your risk log. What risks happened, which risks didn't happen. What new risks showed up, which you weren't expecting. This is good information for the next project. And then we need to update the company databases, the suppliers, the contractors, the risk logs, the lessons learned logs. We need to communicate what we've found, and then we can close the project. And then the next day, when we get a phone call from the customer, we can officially say, well, I'm sorry, you've signed off the project, it is closed. If you want something done, it's going to be a new project. This project audit needs to be done internally quite quickly, while the project is fresh in people's minds, before they move on to the next project where they won't find an hour or two to come to your meeting. It needs to be done perhaps independently, perhaps run by a senior manager or a different project manager. However, externally, we might want to delay this project audit for a short while. Let me give you an example. We've just delivered a customized manufacturing machine to the customer. Internally, the project went as expected. Oh yeah, it was a week late, it was a little bit over budget. We had a bit of a heated discussion with the customer over who should do part of the work in the middle. But you know, the project's finished, we've learned from it. The machine is now at the customer's. If we go and knock on his door and say, how was it for you? He is going to be quite angry with us. He's just spent £1 million on a new machine. Remember, it has not given him any business benefit yet. He doesn't know how to operate it. Yes, you've given him the training, you've done what you said you'd do, but he's unfamiliar with it. It's only running at 60% of his desired speed because he's learning about the new machine. So we delay this review with the customer for 6 weeks, 3 months perhaps. We go and knock on the door and we say, hey, that project we did for you, how was it? He says, fantastic, best machine I've ever had. It's operating at 110% of what I expected. Actually, it's good you're here. I've got some new business for you. So just be careful when you have that review with the customer. Here's some famous project reviews. You could go and Google these or find the links. Do you remember the Scottish Parliament building? It was scheduled to cost up to 40 million and it cost £431 million. And because it was a government project, there was a public inquiry. And the findings of this inquiry say that the lessons learnt were there were management failures of gigantic proportions. Do you know, I'm glad I'm not the project manager with that label on me. People weren't trained. People didn't do their job. There was no discipline on the construction site. And interestingly, the timescale was unrealistic. Think about our triangle of project management. And there was a lack of certainty about what was required. So they didn't know what they were doing, and they didn't have enough time to do it in. So it's unsurprising that the cost went out of control. Or this example of the Mars lander on Beagle. Of course, they don't really know why it crashed because they don't have the data. But the suggestion at the internal report, the lessons learned, was they rushed the project. So aiming for a timescale, you can only launch to Mars at certain times of the year when Mars and Earth are in favorable conditions. A lack of budget. Think back to the NASA video where they said a lack of budget, they made mistakes. The London 2012 Olympics, what was learnt from that? One of the committees involved said that they've learnt to organise regular meetings for the senior managers. Communication, good lessons learnt for any project. And the A380 is a project that we've suggested earlier was delayed, caused the company great financial problem. One of the lessons learnt that I found for that is it's about organizational culture, and that culture affects projects, people being motivated, people working together, and that the key fact for successful projects is having a good culture, an open and honest, a trusting culture where projects can run, rather than a hostile culture where people are going to get blamed and punished. The project review or the project audit will ensure that your project, however bad it is an experience that you've gained. If it's a bad experience you've gained, it means you can learn for the next project. If you don't hold a project review, your next project will be just as bad, maybe worse.